Hello, this is Gabriel. I'm back at the drill press again, showing you one of my favorite jigs that I made back in December 2003. I've used this on many occasions. This is just a basic Harbor Freight 2-inch drum sander, but it's modified. The screws popped out, so I put in some coarse 1-inch drywall screws, and then on the outside of the foam, I contact cemented down a piece of rubber inner tube from a bicycle tire, and that's going to give you the traction for this horizontal belt sander, so gripping that belt. So you're going to want to go ahead and chuck that in, and if you saw one of my previous videos, you saw my use of magnets. I use the half inch rare earth magnets to hold just about everything down. Some people like duct tape and baling wire. I like magnets. So anyway, let me see if this gets on here right. This is the jig, the body of the jig. This is just a regular piece of sandpaper belt that is the same size of my regular belt sander. This is the jig. Well, let me see if I can get that in here just right. It's pretty good size, probably about 20 inches long or so. It's a wooden 2x4 here. It's got a Teflon roller, and that roller on the middle of that, I have some brass bushings I'll show you. But over that wooden 2x4 is a metal 2x4, and it's screwed down. I got a couple of grooves on the back side of it here, so you can see, probably in the video or not. I don't know if you can see that. But top and bottom, and then there's a little bit of a shoulder right here, and that's for the handle on the drill press table, so that when you're cranking that up and down, that's going to give you some clearance. And you'll see the groove right here. That's from the belt actually tracking up and down, and that's why on the back side over here on the other side where the roller is, I made that adjustable for tracking. This right here is just for a vacuum attachment for the shop vac. It works quite well. And on the bottom, you see this is two layers, and the second layer is for the this is what bolts to the or down to the table. And on the back side, you're going to see this L-shaped piece of wood, and that is going to actually sit under the corner over here, and then we're going to bolt that down with a couple of 6-inch clamps. But first, you want to take your belt, you're going to slide that underneath the drum, raise it up, and that slides in under, and that 1-inch clearance gives you enough room for that sanding drum without hitting the first level. And then the second level is actually so that that belt is actually underneath it, so it's a flush sanding surface. So let me pop on a couple of, these are some 6-inch clamps I picked up at Rockler. And on the bottom of that drill press table, I have a couple of pieces of wood epoxied in place underneath, so that the pad will grip underneath on the bottom. They'll both have a flush surface to work off of. So we bolt that down, and it takes only a few seconds, so you can see it's sort of taking shape already. And all you have to do here at this point is just lock that in place, give it some tension, and this is on a slow speed because it's just set for drilling. But anyway, I think you get the idea of what it looks like. And let me see. So that's it. It's a pretty significant tool to use. It helps. I made a miniature spiral staircase out of this, and for all the curving and all the angles, this worked out beautifully for it, and I've used it for a whole bunch of other things since. And you're getting more than use of just, you know, just using your drill press as a drill press. So you're getting double, triple duty out of your tools. And that's all I'm trying to do, is show you how to get some more mileage out of your tools. I hope you like it. If you like it, please like. And I'll be adding some more stuff later. All right, have a good day, and that's it.